Grand Cherokee update. I might as well do a little exterior update before I go on the interior. There's a CB whip so you guys know what I got. It's too actually tall on the roof of the Jeep. It hits the ceiling, so I have to lay it down. I got that for the whip and all the cord and all that shit for 15 bucks off my buddy at school, which isn't a bad deal. Also, updating what's to come on it. I ordered a 2-inch lift forward or an 1¾-inch lift. It'll be in this Thursday. What's today now? 24th. And since today is Tuesday and Thursday is the 26th, since today's the 24th, which means I'll probably have a video this weekend of putting the lift kit in, which is a bonus. Jeep's dirty as all hell, needs a good washing. But if you guys never noticed already, when I was talking, looking at the front, took the bug deflector off, sanded down the surface rust. This line was already here. I sanded it and I couldn't get it out really, so I gave up on it. There's a little line there, but other than that, I did a pretty good job of it. And I sanded down, took all the surface rust off. It don't really quite match, but whatever, this is so goddamn dirty anyways, I need to wash it. Been in here when I was welding, grinding and everything else, and just covered in old dust. And it was outside last night, it rained. But only took the heavy stuff off, so I gotta wait till we get some more sunny weather. There's my Cobra CD I got off my dad, he gave to me. Oh, wrong one, turn on, there we go. It's a 40 channel. Yeah, 40. 40 channel CV has speaker built into the bottom. There's a little clip on the side that holds it, but I can't get that in there because I put that under the dash. I almost didn't put CV in this Jeep because I really didn't want to drill holes in this dash, but I put 4 silt tap and screws through the bottom of it. If it ever gets taken out, you're never going to notice it. Well, I mean, a couple people might notice it, but I mean, whatever. I was thinking about taking that little metal clip off and putting it up here, putting it right here, but I don't want to drill any more holes because, I mean, dash is beautiful shape on this. And since we're staring at a tire, might as well talk about tires. I need a set of 17-inch rims because my father, he got me, he might be getting me, there's a 90% chance, and he's getting them for free. They're a set of Mud Train BFGs or something like that, he said. I don't know, I never seen them, but they're for a 17-inch rim. So with a 2-inch or 1¾-inch lift, I should be able to fit those under it. If I can't, I'm going to cut out the wheel wells and then put a big old flares on it. I like a bear without the bugger deflector, but I need a grill for it still. I need front bumper, back bumper, and single light covers. So single light covers, these little plastic turn single covers, just a solid chunk of plastic that wraps around, as you can see where the tape is. $33 a piece to order. And that's pretty cheap that's the cheapest place around here to get anything at. And it's $60 for a grill. I would have bought the grill and all that, but if I gotta buy that, I gotta buy. There's plastic that's all supposed to be here and it's supposed to come along the bottom like this does. And that's all broke out from the owner before me. The bumper's all coming off. So I have to get, I don't even know what you would call it. Like you can see right here, I got wire holding up my headlight because there's nothing else holding that, and there's a tab that goes into the fender there. But other than that, that's the only thing that holds that light up because the light's supposed to be held in by that plastic shrouding. And that's supposed to run through there, and like I said before, it's all broke out because the lad cut holes in the bumper to wrap a fucking rope around it. Couldn't get much coarser, couldn't wrap it around the axle or nothing, I guess, so put it through there and broke all that shit out. The grill's broke out. And yeah, I did a pretty good job cleaning this up under here, painted, all that. Air breather, my French one. Using my iPhone for light. And cleaned up the motor a little bit, but you know, just half-assed job, gotta clean it again. And as for the back tailgate, as you can see, she's crusty as all hell. Sorry for a shitty light, like I said, use my iPhone. As you can see, she ain't the best of shape. The lever don't work, but that's an easy fix. Big hole there, that's all beat in because the bumper came up and struck it when I used a jackhole, and that's all dented in. But what I want to try to do is it's kind of harder to find the tailgates for these, but since this is just a straight line across this whole thing right here, I think I might get a grinder, get my grinder, and cut this right out along this beveled edge, come across, remove that handle, and just go real, watch what I do so I don't go too deep down on the inside of this and mess up any assembly bullshit, and tack it along. And beat those dents out, obviously. Then Bondo and Kitty hair the shit out of that, and paint that, and hopefully I can save myself from having to buy a trunk lid. Put all this shit back together here. And yeah, because I really kind of don't want to spend, you know, $100, $200 on a trunk lid. And if I can beat those dents out, because they ain't along, there's no bad creases in it. And get behind it and beat it with a hammer, or I can get the suction cup. Right there, it's going to be a little bit harder, but if I can save it, it would be good, because, I mean, I could spend $35 on sheet metal and save that, so it would be worth it. There's no point in trying to cover up these holes of Kitty here in Bondo, because you'd spend more trying to fix the holes, so, I mean, might as well just zip that out with the grinder, get a chunk of metal, fill it in. For right here, it's going to be harder. I might save this piece because I know I can't do that. I'm not a good welder. I can weld, but I mean, I'm not real good. And then put a thin line of Bondo over that and make a little beveled edge. And she's going to be a wood truck, not a show truck. So, you know, ain't too concerned. And start her up before I go for you, since you love my glass pack so much. So yeah, comment, rate, and subscribe, and if anyone wants to, I know it's a big grill on these, but if anyone wants to mail me a grill, or turn single covers, go ahead, or maybe I can buy them and buy and pay for shipping, shit like that. But yeah, comment, rate, and subscribe, tell me what you think, and next time you see this, I'll be pulling the lift in, or the lift will already be in it.